like a roll and replace on the middle pick and roll. He comes up, his feet are set, and he's actually capable of making that shot. It's just when he's shooting that shot off the dribble and everything is where I think he's doing himself a disservice.
Like that previous shot, Brown on the move, pull up, 12-footer, rimming, good. Shot good for Cecil Brown, the former UC Santa Barbara Gaucho who just checked in for Nate Tibbetts.
He played well last night also. I was really impressed with he and Shakur. They really kept playing even though they were down over 20 points. They played hard the entire game.
Yeah, he had 11 points in last night's loss. Curtis Gerald lost the defender, flips it up top for Carter, left elbow jumper, too strong, tipped up off the rim, but not. A goaltending call and the rebound taken by Mullins. Shakur kicks left. Larry Owens jump stop in the lane, should be called for, I thought they were going to call the traveling violation, didn't you?
Definitely. Speaking of LeBron James, that's the LeBron James rule. You can't hop off of one foot and come back down on that same foot into two steps.
They didn't call that, though. They called a foul on the Toros.
Yeah, maybe he's still mad about his refereeing number. I don't know. He just missed that call.
No, the guy who called that, actually, I mean, he's comfortable with his officiating number.
Oh, really? These guys are new.
He's 57.
Really know
he's not as mad
as the 63 guy.
Yeah, 63 is really upset. Owens gets the free throw.
I think we can call him that, the 53 guy, the 63 guy, 57 guy.
I had their names all over the place, but I don't know where they went there.
Well, the 57 guy just made a good call on a baseline.
Yeah,
Larry Owens steps
out
of bounds.
That's Don Hudson. 63 is Ben Taylor.
Ben
and
Taylor.
17 is Scott Twardarski.
You have all the answers, man. You are definitely on top of it.
No, I'm just reading off the stat sheet.
That's still an answer.
All right, 12-11 our score. Toros by a point. 4:47 left to play opening quarter. Toros shooting 46%. And the 66ers 50%. Lonzo G is double team, splits two defenders, gives it to Jones. His layup is good.
This is great. I haven't seen this type of interior passing in a long time. Great unselfishness. Guys are looking for one another even when they have layups for themselves. It's resulting in higher percentage layups.
Shakur to Clark above the right elbow, drives right by Bowen, blocked with a foul, and Clark will go to the free throw line. We started to mention Keith Clark, 6'8", 220, out of Oklahoma. And for those of you watching on Lone Star Sports, there's another look at that interior passing and the lay-in from Dwayne Jones. But Clark, tough kid, was a starter for the first two games, but has a bruised knee and could not go last night. But he's out there tonight giving it a go. Free throw, no good.
Made a nice move to get to the free throw line. Nice little inside pivot on the post. He's 6'8", but he looks to have quick feet. You know, he's a lanky kid. Was able to get by the good defense of Justin Bowen for the foul.
Second free throw up and good. So Keith Clark, the Sooner, splits the pair. And it's a two-point game at 14-12. Gerald dribbles to left elbow, sets up Clinch. Lewis for three. Got it! Lewis Clinch just checked in and connects on the three.
Lewis Clinch is a shooter. Quinn Snyder, recognizing the 66ers playing 2-3 zone since the start of the game, puts in a shooter to shoot him out of that zone. Lewis Clinch comes in and delivers.
Brown straight down Main Street. Layup is good as he got by Clinch.
Yeah, Cecil Brown playing well. Clinch had his offensive shoes on when he checked in the game, but didn't necessarily have his defensive shoes laced up.
Gerald tries to penetrate. His pass deflected over to G in the corner. Plenty of time on the shot clock. No luck pass to Jones in the lane. Spins by his man and lays it in. He got right by Mullins. And another two for Dwayne Jones, who's up to 6 points.
Yeah, that's one of the things Byron Mullins is going to learn, how to, you know, use his size to play better defense. Right there, he was 7 feet, but he let Dwayne Jones just run right by him.
Corner three for Cecil Brown is good as he rattles it home. And Cecil Brown off the bench has 7 quick points to lead Tulsa. For the Toros, 6 for Dwayne Jones. So let's set the lineups for you for the Toros in the backcourt. It's Curtis Gerald and Lewis Clinch, Alonzo G at the 3, Bowen at the 4, Dwayne Jones at the 5. On the move, it's Gerald's. He lost it. Out of bounds. Turnover number 3 on the Toros. For Tulsa, Devon Harden back in. And Cecil Brown goes to the bench. Check that. It's Larry Mullins that goes to the bench. Cecil Brown just walked in front of the bench. So the lineup for Tulsa has Shakur at the point. He's joined out there by Keith Clark, Devon Harden, Larry Owens, and Cecil Brown. Bounce pass down low, nearly stolen by the Toros. Shot clock down to 9. Larry Owens backing down G. Still trying, backing down. Double comes from Jones. Bounce pass in traffic. Kicked out of bounds by the Toros. It's going to belong to Tulsa with 4 on the shot clock. But first, we have a timeout on the floor. Late first quarter, Austin Convention Center. Mark Honig with Malik Rose. Glad you're with us tonight. Toros by 2, 19-17. And Tulsa with possession. Inbounds it goes to Cecil Brown. Gets by his man, puts it off the window. No good. Follow dunk, Devon Harden, who came flying right over the top of Justin Bowen for the follow dunk.
If they make posters in the NBDL, that should be one of them.
I don't know if they have trading cards, but that should be one of those too. Here's Clinch for another 3. This time it's off to the left. High rebound pulled down by Clark of Tulsa as we're tied at 19 with 2:20 to play first quarter. Yeah, Shakur Clark, to his left.
I was saying Clark gives them the 66ers an added live body inside. He's listening. I see why he was starting. He's definitely a lively body, good on the boards. It's going to help them.
Yeah, able to tip in a shot there by Shakur. And Keith Clark has 3 points in the game. Tulsa back in front by 2. Bowen with a beautiful diagonal pass to Jones. Double comes from Clark. Now he's matched up single coverage against Harden and draws the foul. 44 against 44.
Great move.
Devon Harden called for the foul.
I'm sorry about that. Great move by Dwayne Jones there. Took his time in the post, as you see here. Great move. Got Devon Harden leading one way. He's a drop step to get the foul going the other way.
So Dwayne Jones to the free throw line. Toros down by 2. Free throw is good. Toros have led by as many as 6, trailed by as many as 2. Dwayne to shoot one more. He's got 7. And he still has 7. A little bit short on that free throw, but he's got a nice touch for a big man at the free throw line.
Very nice touch. He and Mullins have 2 of the nicest touches for the I've seen on a big man.
What was your career free throw percentage? Do you have any idea?
I know it went up towards the end of my career. I'd venture to say it was 75 and above, close to 80. I was really getting good the end of my career.
Another dunk for Devon Harden. Beautiful assist by Shakur. And Harden, he must have been listening to our pregame show, because we're talking about how the big guys for Tulsa were hovering around the three-point line, and now they're attacking the basket time and time again. Gerald bluffs the shot, flips it over to David McClure, who's just into the game for the Toros. He tries the pass to the corner. It's intercepted. That's turnover number 4 on the Toros. In transition, Shakur to Clark, stolen by Gerald. Gerald, the long lead pass to Clinch, slashing in from the left. He throws it down with the left hand.
Wow, that's impressive. Louis Clinch is a right-handed player. Took off with a left-handed flush on the break.
At only 6'3", too.
Mm-hmm, yeah.
23-22, Toro is down by a point. Shakur feeds Harden and a whistle. And the foul on David McClure, the 6'6" forward out of Duke.
I like David McClure. When he comes in, he's always guarding one of the tougher players on offense. Right now he's guarding Devon Harden. He's a taller, stronger kid. The other night it was Mike Harris, and even though Mike Harris went off on him on offensive end, David McClure didn't back down one bit. He stuck his nose in there and tried his best.
Yemi Akunye fresh into the game, inbounds to Mustafa Shakur, looking for Clark. Instead, veers to the left wing, bluffs the shot against McClure, gives to Harden top of the key. Checked by Okasun, bounce pass to Clark. He shoots, and it is a goaltending violation on the Toros as Okasun batted that thing after it hit the window. Was that going to go in? You think that was going in anyway?
Yeah, that was going in. Keith Clark had a definite size advantage down there. I don't know how Curtis Gerald keeps getting caught on these bigger guys down low. Looks like they're switching pick and rolls at the top, and Curtis Gerald's just getting rolled down to the block, and these guys have a 4 and 5 inch height advantage on them, taking advantage of it.
10 on the shot clock, about an 8-second difference between shot and first quarter clock. Lewis Clinch veers left, fadeaway jump shot, rimming, no good. Tip up from Okasun, won't go. Scooped up by McClure. He throws it off the glass, no. And the rebound taken by the Tulsa 66ers, who race out. 2 seconds left in the quarter. 20-foot jump shot, no good. And the rebound by Alonzo G. And the Toros give up 25 points in the opening quarter and trail it by 3 after 1. Up next, the second quarter here from the Austin Convention Center. 25-22 Tulsa and NBA D-League basketball.